Good evening, everyone. I welcome you all in series of SQLite. This is part two of SQLite triggers. So as we have explained that triggers are very, very important and event-driven functions. Now in this case, SQLite drop trigger, that for an example, in SQLite drop triggers, command is used to drop or delete triggers from a table. So this is the command that drop, then trigger, and trigger name. So trigger name is going to be dropped. And as in the previous video, we have created a trigger audit underscore log. So just use the syntax that we have, drop trigger audit underscore log, follow up by semicolon. So this is the way that we simply find out that SQLite drop trigger works. Now the next example is SQLite of the primary keys. That SQLite primary key is a simple field or a combination of fields which is used to uniquely define a record, and the table can have only one primary key. So we all know whatever the sort of stuff that we have of primary keys, a primary key should not be a null value, which is very, very important. Now creating a primary key is generally created at the time of creating the table. So we define the primary key while executing create table statement. This is the syntax that create table, table name, and follow up with this parenthesis pair. And under this parenthesis pair, we have this column, multiple columns, and the constraint name, primary key. So primary key column 1, 2, 3, and up to column n. So this is the way that syntax of that creation of a primary key. Now, for adding a primary key, it is used when you have not defined the primary key at the time of the create table statement and you have to add a primary key later. So you cannot use alter table statement to create a primary key. Instead, you have to just create a new table with primary key and copy all the data from the old table. So pragmatic syntax is here, where a foreign key is off, and finally begin transactions and alter table. Table underscore name to the old table. So you have to just, you are just to rename that from the old table. So that primary key and copy all the data from the old table, create table, table name, multiple columns are there. And then similar sort of syntax we have, constraint name, primary key, and multiple columns with the primary key. Follow up with the parenthesis and semicolon. So insert into table name, select a star from old underscore table, and then commit. So commit is always there once the transaction is successfully completed. And pragmatic foreign key is on in that particular case. Now here are some parameter explanations. That table name, it specifies a new table in which it includes the primary key. And the old underscore table is, it specifies the table which has to be changed. Constraint name, it specifies the name of the primary key. And these are different columns which makes the primary key. So this is that we have, this is the given example. You may see that employee ID, which is of type integer, then last name, first name, and hire date. So type given is varchar and date. Now run the following commands to make employee underscore ID is a primary key. So foreign key initially off, then begin the transaction and alter table employee rename to old underscore employees. Finally, create table employees, and we have to just set these all the columns name, employee ID, last name, first name, hire date, and constraint with employee underscore PK and the primary key having employee underscore ID. So this is the command, this is the syntax we use for creating a table with employee's name, and the primary key is set to be employee underscore ID. So this is a wonderful syntax that we have to use and remember when we are using this adding a primary key concepts. Rest of these statement, insert into employees, insert into the table that we have created, select a star from old underscore employees. So the table which is initially we had, so we have to just select data from there and finally commit it. And at the end, we have to just on this foreign keys, which is initially off. So this syntax is very, very simple as we just try to remember this general that syntax of this, how to add that primary key into the table. So this concept brings that when we create a table, then at that time we just add these primary keys into a table. So this is the concept that we have. Now, thank you very much being with me in this session. If you like these videos, please subscribe my channel. So till now, we have done lots of concepts-driven videos on SQLite. So you may watch this series of playlist of SQLite right from the beginning. And thank you very much. If you like these videos, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so you may get the notification of the latest uploaded video. Have a nice day.